Jane Barlow, welcome to Women's Wellness Radio.
Thank you so much. I'm so happy to be here and meet you.
Yeah, I'm excited to get to know you. I heard you on my friend's podcast and I had heard your name a few times. I was taking one of your products and I was like, I got to get her on. That was a great interview. So yeah, and we love to get specific here. So we're going to get specific on some herbs. So let's start out with talking about your herbal company. That was once your father's herbal company. So tell us that whole story.
Yeah, so I grew up with a dad who was a medicinal botanist. So that means he made medicine out of plants. In fact, his PhD was his dissertation. All of his study was medicinal botany. So, you know, we grew up in rural Idaho. And so there was, you know, lots of plants everywhere. And it was normal for us, but we would go out and identify plants consistently. Like if we were driving somewhere, my dad saw a plant on the side of the road that he wanted to teach us about. He'd pull over and we'd all get out and, you know, he'd be teaching
us. I
love
it.
Yeah, the medicinal name, the Latin name, what part of the plant you could use. And, you know, you pull these leaves and you can steep them or dry them. Or, you know, this was just a consistent thing growing up. And I really, until I was a teenager, I really just thought that was normal. Everybody did that and took care of their health like that. So, you know, it was a pretty incredible childhood looking back on it, because I was born in 61. So during the 60s and 70s, this is when the food companies were making it really easy for housewives to open cans and packages, and processed foods were really becoming super popular so that the housewives, it would be easier for them. And we never did that stuff. I mean, we made our own bread and we had huge gardens and we did get some canned foods, but, for the most part, you know, we were raised really naturally and, you know, we kind of fought it a little, like when we got to school and everyone was eating the school lunches and we had our brown paper bag lunches. We were like, oh my gosh, I'm so embarrassed. And, you know, you don't realize how good you have it until you're grown up sometimes.
Right. Yeah.
So yeah, it was, there's 14 kids in my family. So
they're insane.
I know. So there were lots of little kids always everywhere. And we really had to learn to take care of each other. And there was always plants and herbs and concoctions and things growing in little jars on the counter. And it was crazy.
So I love to hear about, like, I heard your dad was really studying hard, like the different properties of these plants, and he put them together in certain ways, which I think is kind of the magic behind herbs. Like you need someone, well, not to say you need someone, but someone who can really combine them artfully. Like
right.
That's very powerful. So I wondered how he got started on all that and then how you came to kind of know that and do that as well.
Yeah, well, you know, I think a lot of where his knowledge came from, first of all, was his intense interest in plants and plant medicine, enough to pursue, you know, a degree in it. And there is really an art to putting plants together if you're going to put a combination together, because the medicinal properties of one plant need to complement the properties of another plant. So, for example, we were talking before you started recording about a parasite formula that we have, and it's got black walnut hulls, wormwood, cloves, and quasi chips. Those are all well known for their anti-parasitic properties. But then how do you not only blend them, but in what amounts? So there's an art and a science behind making medicine out of plants. I mean, if you think about every indigenous people that have ever lived on this planet, almost all of them had their own medicine man. Like you would go to the tribal medicine man, like for the Native Americans, and they would make a concoction if you had a stomach ache or a chest cold, or a woman was getting ready to give birth. There was always medicine. And this was an art that was passed down generation to generation in, you know, for each indigenous people. So it's a bit of a lost art that I think is really coming back, because people are realizing that pharmaceuticals are not and shouldn't be your first option. They can have their place in the right situation. But when you learn how to do natural healing on the level that I know how to do, it puts the responsibility squarely on me or on the person who's looking, because I can't go, oh, it's time for me to go to the doctor because I'm feeling all these problems. No, I'm responsible. What am I eating? What am I drinking? I mean, all of it goes together like that. So that was kind of maybe a little bit of a roundabout way with how do you put herbs together, but it is an art. It's a real art.
Yeah. Yeah. So what was his, he was making stuff for you guys at home and little tinctures and stuff, but what was his mission when he like packaged it and took it out to the world?
You know, in the beginning, his mission was to empower other people, you know, to take care of their families the way he knew how to take care of us. And he watched people be overwhelmed because it can get overwhelming, especially as a parent, if your kid gets sick and they have a high fever or they have an infection or they have something that is an issue, we become scared. And he would watch people not trust their own intuition. And we like, you know, something's not really right. Like, I've talked to so many people over the years that they go, they get diagnosed with cancer. They do not want to do chemo. They just intuitively know they just want to do it. They're scared of it, but they don't know what else to do.
Right.
So I think that was his main motivating factor. And he really collaborated with a lot of, you know, well-known people in the natural field. Like, I don't know if you've heard of Dr. Hulda Clark.
Yeah. Yeah.
So he worked with her for many years. He worked with a very famous Canadian nurse who developed a formula called ESIAC or
ESIAC. Oh, yeah. Yeah. I've heard of
that. He worked with her in the late 60s. And then when I was a teenager, we used to take turns going with my dad on business trips. And when I was about 16, I got to go with him to San Francisco and meet Dr. E.T. Krebs Jr., who was the one who with the Krebs cycle.
Oh, wow.
Familiar with that. And there's a whole story about Dr. Krebs and his dad, who was also a physician, and the flu epidemic of 1918. We can definitely talk about that later too. But he really just kind of started to surround himself with people and practitioners who were studying natural medicine on the level that he was interested in. And they did a lot of collaboration.
I love that. I love that. That's my thing. It's collaboration. Yeah. Well, I mostly want to dig into like the herbs you use and the formulas you came up with. So let's start with a bang. Let's talk about this lomatium, which is an herb. Probably I should have somebody email in and give them a dollar if they've heard of lomatium before. It's not that well known.
No, it's not. It's you know, and you might've heard me say this on the other podcast that you heard, but this is my favorite plant. Like, I love all plants, and I'm glad I don't have to just pick one because I use a lot of different herbs and plants for different things. But this, so lomatium is spelled L-O-M-A-T-I-U-M. And it is what's known as a broad-spectrum antimicrobial. And it's a Native American plant. So this was used by the Native Americans for centuries before, you know, the people who immigrated and kind of took over. Now it still grows, but it only grows in the wild. So this is one reason that nobody or a lot of people, even I've talked to master herbalists and many naturopathic doctors who've never heard of this plant.
No.
Yeah.
I hadn't heard of it till the podcast. And then I saw it was in this formula that if you guys are on the video, the formula that I'm taking of yours is in there. So
yeah.
I was like, oh, that's cool. Cause it sounds amazing.
It is amazing.
Tell us what it does. Yeah.
Yeah, so I would say that its main property is that it's antiviral. So if you think about the people that go into the doctor for cold or flu or whatever, and it's a viral infection, we know now that antibiotics don't go after viruses. And this is where it can be like, we can suffer for a long time until our body gets well. But its main property is antiviral. I mean, I have two boys, they're 35 and 36 years old. They've never had a prescription antibiotic. I raised them on this plant. And I now have a couple of grandkids who use it. It's very safe for babies. So I gave it to my kids and grandbabies when they were just a couple of months old, when they needed
it. Wow.
So it's very, very safe. It's very, very effective. It doesn't just go after virus. It goes after fungus. It goes after yeast. It also has some properties that make it important in that formula, that bottle you held up, which is an anti-parasite formula that goes specific for Giardia. It's in there too, because the properties of lomatium complement the herbs that are in the other herbs, black walnut, tansy, that's in the vermicide. So, but if you heard me also, There's a big but.
There's a but. But before we get into the but, I want to point out that you, I noticed you do pair it, you put it in a lot of formulas, and you say that way you don't get as much of the but if you mix it with other herbs, but tell us the but.
Okay. So there's about 10% of the adult population that when they take this plant for the first time, and if it's a full root extract, because the part of the plant we use is the root, and there, it does need to be, after you pull it out of the ground, we chop it up into slices and we lay it out on drying racks because it needs to oxidize. Once we chop it up, it oozes all of these beautiful oils.
Oh, wow.
And that part of what makes it work and makes it powerful, and part of what makes the rash happen is the oxidation. Because you can take a fresh root extract of lomatium and you don't get the rash.
Okay.
But it doesn't have the same power as the root that's been oxidized. So there are some plants that need to be made fresh. Mm-hmm. And there are some plants that need to go through a drying or an oxidative process too. So with lomatium, when it goes through the process and then we put it into a liquid tincture and we also put it into a capsule product, this about 10% of the people will get a one-time full body detox rash. It looks like measles, a little bit like scarlet fever. If people have looked up on the line, you know, they've looked up online, especially people that have never heard of the rash, and we have it on the bottle, but it just says you could get a rash. We can't put all the information that people need to have. And it can be a really scary, horrific.
Is it like all over your body or depends?
No, most people, it's all over their body. It doesn't start all over the body. Like I just spoke to a lady a couple days ago who was having, she had infection in her thyroid. She'd been having problems. She had Epstein-Barr and her main problem was in her thyroid. And she started taking lomatium, and the rash shows up between about days 5 and 7. So it doesn't usually show up on the first couple of days. So it's really classic. And at about 7 days, she broke out in the rash first on her neck and chest, okay, which was where her infection was. People with like kidney infections or UTIs, it'll show up on the low back, like where the kidneys are, or on the low abdominals.
Oh, wow.
So it really, but then it spreads. Then it goes all the way, arms, legs, head. Some people get it light. But if you've had like a systemic viral issue that's kind of been stuck in your tissues, what this plant allows your body to do is to push it out. And your skin is your largest organ, and your liver can't handle the detox, so the skin's just helping out. And it happens once. It is miserable and itchy and scary, and it's actually a very emotionally intense experience for some people because you are literally having a healing crisis.
Wow, yeah.
I've talked to many people off the ledge from their rash. And
so it's really itchy and it's hard to get rid of. And does it last a few days?
It runs its course. It usually goes anywhere from 3 days to 7 days. There's usually a part in there where it's at its worst. And some people, signs of the rash will linger. Like you'll see faded of it, like for a couple of weeks, maybe even 3 weeks, just faded.
Okay.
But it eventually goes away. And so this alone, just talking about this rash and how horrible it is, makes people go, oh no, that's not for me. And in a way that's too bad, but.
Yeah, but it's good you're being honest about it and people know, you know, ahead of time. So when, like for this woman you talked about who had I have the same thing. I have Epstein-Barr and other things that I think led to some low level autoimmunity in my thyroid. Do you think like the pure is best for her, or you do have some mixed formulas as well?
Yeah. So about 10 or 12 years ago, so my dad passed away 20 years ago, and I restarted his company 4 years after he passed away. None of my siblings were interested. You know, my dad was this rebel. He was kind of underground. The IRS didn't know where he was. He didn't pay taxes. Seriously. And he used to smuggle his alcohol for his tinctures across the Mexican border. And he was just this amazing, smart, kind of mad scientist plant guy. And nobody wanted to run my dad's company the way he did it.
Sure. So,
yeah. Rightly so. So it kind of died with him. And we started to get a little bit harassed by these practitioners who were like, one of you guys needs to carry on your dad's work because we need these in our practice. So none of my siblings wanted to do it. We were all kind of deep in our own careers. You know, I used to own a health club here in Salt Lake, and you know, I was deep in what I was doing, and I just felt like, you know, I need to do this. So when I brought my dad's formulas back, I started realizing, oh my gosh, this rash thing is really intense. And I was spending all of my time talking to people and educating them about what their body was doing. So I started researching. I'm like, there's got to be a way that we can prevent and lessen the chances of people getting a rash. So this is where some collaboration came in. Luckily, I have a pretty large database full of doctors who buy from us. And I started collaborating. And what we find is when we support and detox the liver using things like dandelion root, milk thistle, things like this, that we're able to prevent the rash in most of the people who use Lomation for the first time. So this is where Immunity Boost was born. So this is one of my formulas, and it has 25% Lomation in it. And then it has dandelion, it has red root. Red root helps clear mucus out of the organs. And then it's got a total of 7 herbs in it. And it's actually has become extremely popular because it's great for allergy season. And it's also really good during cold and flu season. So we suggest that people start with that.
Okay. So like that example you gave of the thyroid, could she start with that? And then yes. If it seems like not quite strong enough, switch over?
No, it'll be strong enough. But the thing that you're trying to do is not only prevent the rash, but to acclimate the body to Lomation.
Oh, and, you know, I see.
Okay. So I would suggest going through one bottle of the Immunity Boost. So even though it says, you know, it's Immunity Boost, but we took the I off, it's not necessarily something for the immune system. It's not a specific. It still is antiviral, antimicrobial, but it also will clear those issues out. So it allows the immune system to do its job without those issues in the way. So there is, but it doesn't stimulate the immune system. So I would just suggest no matter what viral issue someone's dealing with, they always start with a bottle of Immunity Boost. Now in your case, you've got the parasite formula with the Lomation in it. I would say, yeah, you don't have to go through a bottle of Immunity Boost. You can go straight after you finish that. And I would suggest that you do. You should be able to go straight for the pure LDM, which is pure Lomation.
Okay. Interesting. This was really helpful. Okay. So the Immunity Boost, a good starter, and we'll link to your website so people can check that out. Yeah. I mean, I think chronic viruses are a major problem, and yeah, in my little world, everyone has chronic viruses. You know how it is when you get something, you think everyone has it. So I think a lot of people are dealing with mold from their homes and schools and workplaces. A lot of people are dealing with yeast from eating sugars and EMF and who knows what. And then viruses, I think chronic viruses are real, and they're really affecting things like our thyroid and our cancer risk and that kind of a thing. So yeah, I would encourage people to explore it if you've been diagnosed or if you've been kind of self-studying and think, this might be something that I need.
Yeah. I mean, I really believe we all have, I mean, we're the perfect biology for virus and yeast and fungus and parasites. And the problem I believe is not just an overuse of antibiotics, but the foods we eat, they leave our body in a less optimal environment because we're really designed, our immune system protects us from all those things. You know, we get a virus, our immune system should be able to go, all right, I see what this is, and I'm going to build you some antibodies, and then you're going to be fine. But because we throw all this unnatural food at ourselves, and we eat way too much sugar, and then we get really super sick, and we've, you know, taken antibiotics throughout our lives, it just leaves us in a kind of a compromised position to handle something like a virus. You know, I feel really blessed that I'm in a situation where I don't worry about anything. You know, I don't worry if I get cancer. I don't worry about, I mean, this is a wicked flu season right now. It feels like it's kind of been worse than some of the previous years. This just seems like what we get because of what we do. We, you know, we talk to people all over the country and people in other places of the world, and I'm telling you, this is a wicked cold and flu season right now. And to be well and stay well and not worry, is a big blessing.
Yeah, it's a real pain in the butt when you have colds and flus. It really is.
It stops your life and makes you feel horrible.
Yeah, yeah. And when you're weakened, I mean, I think this has been a weak area for me on and off at times in my life. I'll get 5 or 6 colds a winter. It's ridiculous. It's like, yeah, I know.
Now you know me.
Yeah, well, I'm going to fix that.
Yes.
Yeah. And I think if you are doing that, you got to say, hey, something's wrong here. I think I had chronic virus and probably mold before I even started studying this stuff. I just didn't know about it.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's good to explore, like, that's not normal. So I'll add to your list with foods and everything, stress for sure. Like,
oh yeah.
Chronic stress. Yeah. A friend of mine, she's super, has great habits and all that, but she was just traveling to all these conferences and like speaking and like great stuff, but it's just too hard on you. And she was completely crashed out afterwards, you know, with the flu and fever and couldn't get out of bed. And it's like, that was too much, girl.
Yeah.
So
we gotta
balance that too. So let's talk about some of your other formulas. Let me get down to your website here and we can.
Yeah, do some fun stuff for sure. In fact, I sometimes, you know, I kind of wish that I could collaborate with my dad, because I think he would be surprised that I was the one doing this. A little, you know, because I have 5 brothers, and none of my brothers, they sometimes they help with the, when we harvest the lomatium, but for the most part, you know, I think my dad is, well, you know, I feel his presence on a regular basis, but I've developed quite a few formulas of my own in the last recent years, and I think he would be proud and surprised. And yeah,
I want to start with some of those. I saw a blog you wrote, Colin, something like things you take every day.
Is
calling all women who need a boost. Is that it?
Maybe.
Let me see here. Oh yeah. It's about your supplement routine, and some things on there. Maybe let's start with talking about your Truly turmeric formula.
Okay. Yeah. So, what I find is as I've gotten older, I have people always ask me, what do I do? You know, because I'm not on any medications. I never have been. I probably take a lot of supplements, but for me, it's a dialed in routine, and everything I take is specific. So the turmeric, I'm super active. Like I said, I used to own a gym. I did personal training. I actually still teach step classes at the local gym here in Salt Lake, just because I'm so addicted to exercise. Not in an unhealthy way, but it just is part of what makes me feel good. So about 17 years ago, I started taking turmeric because it was like, all right, this is a natural anti-inflammatory. It provides anti-cancer benefits. There's so many benefits to turmeric, I would start to have, sometimes if I would over exercise, I would get inflammation in my knees or in my shoulders, or it was just a natural way to not have to take ibuprofen. So, turmeric is something I've been taking a long, long time. Now, what a lot of people don't realize is that turmeric is very hard for your body to absorb. So when you take a turmeric supplement, if you add a little tiny bit of black pepper, there's a compound in black pepper called piperine. And piperine releases an enzyme in your liver that allows your body to absorb and assimilate turmeric. So if you think about Indian cultures, like in India, where they use a lot of turmeric in curries, there's usually always pepper in with the curry and in the turmeric that they're using. So they're automatically getting that in the food. So this is, to me, a missing component of some of the turmeric supplements, because you want to get the most out of your supplement. You know, if you're going to take it, you want your body to be able to go, okay, I know what to do with this. And sometimes this is where the combination comes in. This is where the education, you know, and I have people ask us all the time, well, what about just curcumin? I've heard that's like the best pure curcumin. Well, curcumin is part of turmeric. That's part of what makes turmeric turmeric. But look at that as like a beta carotene and out of a carrot. So
okay, yeah, you know, it's like the whole. That's a great point.
So you take the whole, like a beta carrots have 200 different beta carotenes. You don't want to just take one out and go, this is just as good as eating a carrot. So that's kind of the same. You know, turmeric is not a hard supplement. It shouldn't cost you $80 for one bottle of curcumin. I mean, it's a very easy, accessible, even organic So turmeric is awesome.
Do you have to do anything else to the turmeric to make it more absorbable? Like some people pair it with fat or like, I don't know.
It is fat soluble. So yes. So I either take mine with like my krill oil supplement, or okay, I eat it with a meal, because there's usually always some type of fat, like avocado or olive oil or, yes, I always take my turmeric with a meal, or if I'm taking it in the morning, like before I go to the gym, I'll take a krill oil supplement with it.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. Let's talk about another one, a product that I've been getting into lately, which is the chlorella.
Yeah.
Tell us why you take that every day.
Okay. So growing up, I got a ton of silver in my teeth, because this was kind of before, I think, you know, I hate to blame it on genes, but all of my siblings, we all, by the time we became adults, we all had, we didn't go to the dentist a lot, but when we got to become adults and started going to the dentist and taking care of our teeth, we all had a ton of dental caries, a ton of dental cavities. And most of us got, like I had four quadrants full of silver fillings. And when I was about 39, this was about a year before I restarted my dad's company, I started really going, oh my gosh, I need to get the silver out of my teeth. So I started researching the safest way to do that, not just with a holistic dentist, but what supplements would help support my body while I was removing my silver fillings. And chlorella, it needs to be broken cell wall chlorella. But what it does is it attaches to heavy metals and helps your body express the metals, whether it's mercury, aluminum, whatever, but you can express it through or expel it through your urine. So it took me about a year and a half to get all of my silver out because I was really strategic about it. And I was doing about 10 chlorella a day during that whole time. And I just kind of discovered, well, there's mercury in some fish. And even though I don't use deodorant with aluminum anymore, I think we're just exposed to certain amounts of heavy metals throughout our day. And so now I do sometimes two a day, sometimes four. But I figured that's just such a nice, you know, heavy metals are neurotoxins. You know, they accumulate in our brain.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
So chlorella is a smart, easy superfood, super easy to take.
Yeah, I think that's one we're going to carry in our shop. And I found we have a mold group on Facebook, and I find that a lot of people take it as like a binder when they've been exposed. So it seems to bind other things to besides heavy metal. And it gives you B12 and like some other B vitamins too. So it is energizing. So yeah, I like that product. And maybe one that's similar, I guess you could say, is spirulina, which I think you call that formula anti-aging, or
we just name it anti-aging. But so spirulina is very well known as a superfood. But what I really love about it is that it's naturally high in protein, and it's got all of your complete amino acids and all of your complete B vitamins. So for a long time I was vegetarian, and I have in the last few years kind of started eating a little bit differently, where I'll add meat in selectively and carefully. And, but I just feel like all the benefits of spirulina, because of its complete profile, is again, super easy. So I have it actually in powder form that I'll scoop into a smoothie in the summer.
Oh, okay.
But it's nice to take all throughout the year because of just how amazing it is. And really it's a food, just like turmeric's a food. Chlorella is really, it's a blue green algae, and spirulina is definitely, they're all like foods.
Okay, great. Yeah. You know, it's funny. I still have this, I guess you could say, hang up from when I was practicing Chinese medicine, that like spirulina is cold, or maybe it was chlorella. I think it was spirulina. It has a cold nature. So I need to do a little research more into that. I mean, it's funny. You're not taking smoothies in the winter, probably for the same reason. Like it's kind of has a cold nature. Yeah. So I need to look into that a little more and just see like if some people don't tolerate it in some quantities or something like that.
Yeah. And I think everyone is a little bit different, even though we have some similarities, you know, and we source both our spirulina and chlorella from a very good organic source off the coast of Hawaii. So, you know, I'm super picky about what, you know, anything that goes in any of our stuff. It's like, I've been doing the spirulina, the chlorella, the turmeric, and then the other one with the cayenne in it. I've been doing that since I was about 39, all four of those. And for years, people would say, ask me what I take, and I would tell them, and they'd say, well, can I get those from you? And it was like, no, here's my sources. And then I finally was just like, you know what, I need to provide these for people. So we've had them out for about 5 or 6 years.
Okay.
But simply,
yeah, that's kind of how I feel too. Like, I, if there's products I love, I want to get people to get their hands on them and know, like, it's a safe source, like you said.
Yeah.
Yeah. Talk a little bit more about this Heart Love Cayenne product.
Yes. Okay. So Heart Love. Heart Love is, so it's got cayenne pepper, cinnamon, and slippery elm. Now, originally it was just plain cayenne pepper in a capsule. And we also do it in a liquid. We make a liquid tincture of cayenne pepper. So cayenne pepper is very, very heart healthy. It's known as a vasodilator. When I was 14, I was, we were living in Idaho. My dad, you can drive in rural Idaho when you're 14, because a lot of kids grow up on farms and they need to drive the tractors and stuff. Right. So I was out practicing driving with my dad, and we went to the gas station to fill up. And this was before you could swipe your credit card on the pump. And so we went in to pay, and there was an older couple ahead of us. And they stepped out of line up and we stepped up to pay, the man literally, classically, clutched his heart and fell to the floor.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. And so my dad, two things, he carried a wad of cash in his pocket here, and in his pants pocket, he carried a small 1 ounce bottle of liquid cayenne. That was my dad. Money, cayenne, right? Strange, but he's a botanist. That's how he was. So within like 10 seconds, my dad was on the floor next to him, and two droppers full of this liquid cayenne pepper were down this guy's throat. And so it was probably 60 seconds.
What's it doing? Is it dilating or bringing out clots or...
Basically that it's a vasodilator. So it basically opens up a heart. You have to be careful. You can't make claims, but to me, it's so heart healthy. It's stroke prevention, heart disease prevention. I just think it's so healthy for your heart muscle. It's so good for, digestion and metabolism. So it helps increase body temperature. Mm-hmm. Cayenne pepper can actually heal an ulcer, which would seem counterintuitive, because if you take cayenne pepper, it might actually burn an ulcer. If you have an ulcer, it's going to be uncomfortable, but it actually is nourishing it and healing it. So, you know, cayenne pepper is, especially for people who don't like spicy foods, and I'm one of those people, to take it every day. So initially we had it just in plain cayenne, but people would get it and then they wouldn't take it because the capsule would break open in their stomach and it would be uncomfortable. It'd feel like heartburn. So it's uncomfortable. So we added cinnamon because cinnamon is also very heart healthy. It also helps to balance blood sugar, and it's a very warming herb, just like cayenne. And then slippery elm helps to cleanse and purify the blood. And it also contains mucilage, which helps to coat the stomach and helps your body absorb the heat without the discomfort.
Okay. Yeah. I used to love spicy food when I was younger, but now I find, and I still love it, but I'll find the next day I'm like, oh, it's like kind of giving me like IBS reaction, which is not so fun.
Exactly. So that's where you blend it with these other things, and it stops that altogether.
So it sounds, I mean, cinnamon's also good for blood sugar, cayenne, like you said, circulation. And I think people use it a lot for like, if you're catching a cold. So I feel like this formula has some nice multi-uses. I say that kind of to myself and to my audience, because honestly, it's hard for me to think about heart health. Like, I just am like, oh, you know, that's like for old people. But it's not. But yeah. It's like, I think for me to know like, hey, there's multiple things going on if I took that formula. I mean, we can be a little more apt to take it.
Well, not only that, to me, you know, it's about prevention, because we don't usually express a problem that's been kind of maybe an underlying thing until it causes a big problem.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So it's like when someone gets diagnosed with a tumor that started out small, and maybe you had it for years and years and years, and then it expresses because it's big and it's maybe cutting off something or, you know, causing you an issue. So I think the same thing with heart disease. I think besides the lifestyle factors with nutrition, low stress, exercise, sleep, I mean, all those things play a role. But if you can take something simple like cayenne pepper with a little cinnamon and slippery elm in it, you're preventing. So that when we get to be 80, we have a good strong heart, you know, that's.
Yeah. 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 It's a good point. Yeah. I see a lot of our clients who are trying to eat well, they still have dysregulated blood sugar, and that is a heart risk factor as well.
Yeah, agreed.
So yeah, it's another way to take care of it. I love it. Okay. Let me see what else I wanted to dig into on your website.
You're so cute.
No, I was reading this. I'm like, I love all this stuff. How about let's get into, I know. Let's talk about the brain glow and then I'll go into parasites.
Okay. So brain this is glow. Cool. This, yeah. I feel like brain glow is a little inspired because what happened is I went to a conference almost 4 years ago, and I heard an incredible lecture by a very well-known brain doctor, and I don't really want to say his name because what happened is I was extremely inspired and motivated, and I looked at his supplement line after the conference was over because I was like, oh my gosh, I need to start taking care of my brain, like on a level of a really something that's maybe a nootropic or a brain support. I needed to do something more than just what I was already doing. So I wasn't that impressed with his supplement line. There were some good things in it, but it was, I think I know too much, more than the normal person. So I was like, okay. So I started looking at everything that was out there. I looked at every brain support, brain boost, every nootropic. And I looked at everything. And then I just thought, well, none of these are ones that I would want to take and want to take for longevity. Because when you get on a brain formula, you take it longevity. Like you do the cayenne, you take it forever. So I feel like I'm a mad scientist in my lab, like seriously channeling my dad. And I started researching and I gathered up a list of herbs that all support brain function. And I had about 48 herbs on this initial list. And then I have two doctors that I feel grateful to collaborate with. And I started formulating and I started playing around with different combinations. And when this herb meets this herb in what amount, what happens, and what it took me about 2 years to formulate Brain Glow. And it's been out for this summer, it'll be 2 years. So it's been out about a year and a half, and it's exceeded my expectations. I mean, my goal was to prevent dementia and Alzheimer's and to provide like oxygenation and mental clarity. Because every afternoon I get a cup of green tea because if I have some content to put out or I just need to get through my day, sometimes I need a little kick of caffeine. And that's something I wanted to stop doing too, like on a need to basis, like, okay, green tea is great, but I don't want to go, I have to have my green tea.
Yeah. So, yeah. Yeah. So, I'm the same way still in the afternoon. I still like dip and crave a little bit. And sometimes I'm good and sometimes I'm not, but I would love something like this to just.
Yeah. Well, in fact, let me tell you, I got last week, there's a guy, he's a chiropractor, and he was a chiropractor for the Utah Jazz, which is the basketball team here in Utah, for 26 years. And he has a practice that's about 45 minutes north of where I live. And he's been buying my products for a long, long time. He knew my dad, and he called me up last week, and he's kind of this, he's a little bit egotistical, but not in a bad way, because he sees Olympic athletes. In fact, all like John Stockton and Karl Malone, they still, even though they're retired, they still come into his practice and get treated by him. And he sees all these Olympic skiers, and he's just a really well known for elite athletes. And so there's a little bit of ego going on with him, but he's awesome. So he calls me up last week and he says, "So Jane, what's up with Brain Glow?" And I was like, "Well, what do you mean?" And he's like, tell me about Brain Glow. And I'm like, I have no idea where he's going with this.
Right, right.
And I'm like, my first thought is, okay.
Well, I'm in trouble for some reason.
Right. So I tell him the story, what I just told you. And then he's quiet for a second. And he says, "Well, I have to tell you, I've been taking it for a week and a half, and I have never had more clarity and focus in my whole life." He said, "I have ADHD. He's 68 years old. And he's got this amazing gift with the way he practices, but he's never been able to make it as big as he's wanted to go online. He's wanted to do all these great things. And he just poured his, it was the most amazing conversation. And I hung up and I was like, oh, wow. So I get that on a regular basis.
Wow. That's great. I want to try that for sure. So when you say, is it like, can you use it in a small dose for kids?
Yes.
Okay.
This has been an unexpected benefit. In fact, I've had kids as young as 9 go off their ADHD medication because of it.
Wow.
I have a very good friend who's 3-year-old, serious ADHD, and didn't want to put him on any medication. So he broke open a capsule and put about a third of it in with some applesauce and gives it to his son. He's been doing that since last summer.
Okay.
With very good results. So you just take the dose down. There's no chemicals in it. It's really pure. There's 8 herbs in it.
Okay.
They're in the perfect combination. Everything in there is safe for teenagers and kids. And like I said, this was not a, you know, I'm thinking this is adult. This is an adult nootropic.
Okay. I want to try it for sure. Cause I'm working through my own heavy metals and yada, yada, but it's still like my brain just can't recall things occasionally. And
I cannot wait to get some in your hands.
Oh, good.
It's going to blow you away. Seriously.
Oh, good. I'm so excited. Okay. Yeah. Last thing I'll ask you about, and then I want to hear about your resources, is your parasite products, parasite candida. You have a parasite candida pairing.
Yes.
Yeah. Tell us more.
So we're the perfect biology for parasites and yeast. Okay. So a lot of people don't think about parasites. I mean, it's just not something we normally see. Unless you get ringworm, then you can see the signs. Or if you see something in your stools that looks a little bit, you know, So this was the formula my dad created after he worked for many years with Dr. Hulda Clark.
Okay.
And so that's why it's named Clarkia. So it's a broad spectrum anti-parasite, ringworm, tapeworm, any type of intestinal flukes, whether they're in your intestines, your blood, your organs. It's very broad spectrum. It's very effective. And the reason we pair it with the anti-candida formula, which we call these are both my dad's original formulas called mycoside, is because if someone has a parasite infection, they probably have candida. And if someone has a candida overgrowth, they probably have a parasite problem because they feed off each other. They provide the perfect environment. You know, if you have a candida overgrowth, parasites are like, hell yeah, this is a great place for me to be. I'm going to lay all my baby eggs and I'm going to just grow because it's just such a thriving environment for parasites. Yeah. So people that have candida probably have a parasite. It's not anything to freak out about. It's something to go, okay, now I'm going to be proactive and I'm going to clean up my diet. This is such a great reason to get rid of sugar. If you're a sugar, you know, for your sugar person, just the thought of that, because I've talked to people before and it's like, look, here's what happens when you eat a lot of sugar and maybe you go on a couple rounds of antibiotics. It's like, your body's like, hello. So just knowing and learning this stuff can make people go, all right, I'm going to cut the sugar.
Sugar isn't like bad or good. It's just like, what is sugar doing to your body? And can you tolerate that? You know,
right.
And
right.
I sure can. It kind of stinks sometimes.
It does, because it tastes so good, right?
I just blow, everything blows up so quickly. I can just tell. Oh, no, you still can't have that. So yeah. I like how you have this, as you said, you can do it twice a year. You know, because like I told you offline, you know, we do testing and it's fantastic because you can get really specific with your protocols, but not everyone can afford it. And, you know, it's like, can we do something that's safe? And you do it twice a year. Yeah. If people have pets, people work outside. I mean, there's a million reasons you could have a parasite. I think, I don't know. I mean, it's probably hard to say how many of us do, but I'd venture to say that most of us do.
I think most of us do. Whether or not they get a chance to really proliferate and grow in your body is up to you, like how you take care of yourself. Because I think, you know, I studied Dr. Bruce Lipton's work on a pretty heavy basis. I've met him. I've listened to a lecture. I love him. And he has this really great lecture that I've sent a lot of people to and listened to multiple times myself. And he, at the beginning of the lecture, he says, we all have everything that we're going to express. We all have virus, bacteria, yeast, parasites. We all have these in our system. We already have these. But whether or not, you know, our body expresses them into disease or causing us problems depends on how we take care of ourselves, the environment we provide for our body, our perception of the environment, which, you know, our belief systems make a big role. So it's not just how you take care of yourself, but if you believe you're going to get sick, you know, I've seen people believe themselves into cancer, and that sounds horrible, but I've seen it. I have a couple of close friends who I watched over a 30-year period believe that because family members had a certain type of cancer, that they were going to get it. And they did all the lifestyle things right, but because they believed it so strongly, you know, I really do believe that we already have them. So let's just make sure they don't take over.
I like the, you know, do it every couple times a year thing. And like maybe that same month, you get to clean up your diet, you know, do some other nice intentional things. I'm sure that it's beneficial for your digestive tract in general, right?
Yeah. I mean, so I do that, what we just talked about, the parasite cleanse and the candida cleanse every January and every July. In fact, I'm just wrapping up. It's the last day of January today. And I have a little bit left in each bottle, so I'll just finish those out in the next couple of days. And to me, this is just prevention. You know, it's like, and it does dial me in. Like, it's kind of like, okay, I maybe, you know, because I think every human, there's no human that's perfect. You know, I don't eat perfect.
Right. It
just kind of dials my nutrition really back in during those months and refocuses me, which is really nice.
I love it. So we'll link to your website so people can check out these formulas and get these formulas. And you're very generous about answering questions. And, you know, so if people have a question, they could ask. Any other resources you want to mention? You want to mention your course coming up, or is that like still not quite for the public?
Well, so I just launched a course in January, and I opened it up to all my current customers. It's a private course where I get to have, and I'm going to be adding information into the course throughout the whole year. But it's kind of nice because I can say things that I normally can't say in like a public forum, like on my YouTube channel. I have a bunch of videos on my YouTube channel that, but they're kind of soft stuff.
Very public, yeah.
Yeah, because it is public. And so I launched the course for a week in January, and then I closed it because I really want to focus on putting the content out. I'm going to relaunch it again next January. But if anyone's listening to this, if you're interested in coming into the course, it's $197. There's not going to be any exams. There's no tests. It's for you to log into this course and learn. And I'm going to be teaching throughout this year how to make a tincture, how to make a salve, I'm going to even have a module, how to make your own homemade soap, because I make my own homemade soap. And I'm going to go out this spring and summer and fall with a video team. And I'm going to show you how I collect lomatium.
Cool.
So there's going to be a lot of cool content. So if anyone's interested in that, email me directly and I'll get you into the course if you're interested.
I've really put you on the spot with that. So people could also wait till next year's course when it's a little more polished. Is that probably what I should have set you up
for? No, that's totally okay because there's already a lot of really good information in there. I've only had it going for 2 weeks.
Okay.
And this year's going to be insanely fun. There is going to be a bit of a learning curve, and I'm going to find out what people want so that I can polish up the course and, you know, feedback.
Like the beta version. Yeah. I think that's smart. It's really smart because you have your impression, and then other people will give you their impression of what's going on.
Exactly.
I love it. Well, I'm super excited. I want to try more formulas and look into carrying them on our shops just to get access. But yeah, in the meantime, people can just go to your shop. That totally works.
Sharing the love, right? I mean, to me, it's like, you know, make sure your sources are good. Make sure your sources are clean. It's not just about, you know, oh, buy my stuff. To me, it's like, you know, there's lots of good companies out there and lots of good sources. So I think that, and I can even point people in the direction of places and sources, like, where do I get my organic tea? I'll totally tell you.
Yeah. And I could never carry all your stuff, you know, but I'd like to, you know, just introduce people to your company and that kind of a thing.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much, Jane Barlow. We really appreciate your time and your expertise. And glad you reopened that company.
Yeah, it's been almost 17 years now. Crazy, right?
All right. Thanks. We'll keep in touch.
Thanks, Bridget. Nice to talk to you.